Hi guys, and welcome to Creations by Autumn. Today we're going to be putting together the next piece of our next step of my waxing process. So I have this already, our transfer laid down on there. So I'm going to put this to the side real quick so I can show you guys that particular process. So what I have is the palette board from from yesterday's video. So this palette board has been waxed yesterday in yesterday's video. I waxed it for you guys and showed you how I wax it. Once I wax it, I let it sit 24 hours, and then the next day I do the next step, which is I will get just a regular towel and wipe any of the debris off that's left onto it off. Just wipe it off nicely, just straight across, just to kind of get any dirt that might have set on it the next day. Just wipe that off and then put the towel to the side and I'm ready to design. So that is kind of what I do when it comes to waxing. The min wax, particularly the min wax, if you get the min wax, which I show in the last video, and maybe a few videos before yesterday's video, but if you do decide to purchase the min wax states in the directions that you can let it set for 15 minutes and then you can start your design. If you do that, that's completely fine. That's just up to you. I usually let mine sit 24 hours or overnight so that I can make sure that, you know, my waxing is precise. So that's why I let it set overnight. If you do 15 minutes, make sure you do 15 minutes. If you go over that, that's perfectly fine, because like me, I do mine. I wax it for and let it sit overnight. So long as it's 15 minutes or more, then you're perfectly fine. You don't want to wipe it off too soon and then you risk damaging maybe your transfer, or maybe peel up some of your paste when you paste it, or even if you're using raw wood and the wood is more flaky, when you peel up your transfer and you wiped off the wax, it could possibly peel up some of your raw wood, some of the wood. So you don't want that. So making sure it's 15 minutes or a little bit longer, that's perfectly fine. Nothing less than 15 minutes. But that's just with the min wax. There's other different types of waxes that you may want to read the directions and make sure that how long they require you to leave your wax on the surface. So since this is the next day, I wiped it off nice and neatly. And so I'm ready to use it. So I'm gonna put that to the side. And I have my surface, my transfer here, which remember we have to make sure, I'm gonna put my camera down just a little. We have to remember that we need to fuzz our transfer. And you know, I've already started fuzzing this, and I've used this before, and I've mentioned before in other videos, if you have new transfers, it's good to maybe wax maybe more than four times to kind of get a good bit of fuzzing on the back. But I've used this, I'm only going to do it maybe two or three times. If I need more, then I'll do more, but just two or three times will be good. And your transfer is ready to go. You can put your surface to your fuzzing cloth to the side, and then you can let your transfer. So this particular transfer that I have is for Club Couture members. So if you become a Club Couture member for the month of June, you will get this particular transfer, which it says nothing can dim the light that shines from within, and it's by Maya Angelou. So what I'm gonna do is just get my surface. And as you can see, I'll show you guys once I get it laid down. As you can see, I have some of the transfer hanging off. I'm going to use that, but I'm going to use it a little bit later. And then I have some up here hanging off. That's completely fine because I'm not going to use it. And the surface is smaller than this particular one. Unless I turn it this way, but I'm not using it that way. So that's how you do. Also, if you fuzz the inside, I mean, if you wax the inside, I didn't fuzz this side, but you can also use this side also. So it's really, really a great tool. This particular surface is on my chalk site. So I'll put that in the description if you want to look at these palette signs. They're super, super cute. So once I get my transfer laid down and smoothed out the way I want it, I can put this to the side and start to mix my paste. I'm only gonna use one paste color this time. I'm not gonna do multiple. And remember, it's a chunky consistency. So with this one, I'm gonna spray because it looks a little different to me. And then I'm gonna use one stair stick to kind of like mix up the chunkiness of it. Get it smooth, nice and smooth. And then I can use it for my transfer. Nice and smooth. You can use however much you need to use in here. Not too much though, because it doesn't stay chunky very, very long. So once you get it a couple sprays and mix it up, that should be good. Unless you have one of those pastes that takes a little bit of care, a little bit more care than your others, then you may have to use more sprays than that. I'm just getting all of the chunky pieces off the side so I won't accidentally put that onto my transfer. And then it's mixed nicely. Okay, so I'm gonna put that right there so you guys can see. And then bring my board back. And then I have a mini squeegee, which is that size, but I'm gonna be using my bigger squeegee. Just to kind of go over, because I'm just doing one color, so I won't need any different areas than what I had. So I'm gonna just get a good amount on my squeegee and just go all the way. I'm gonna put a good amount across the sides and just go all the way. Just work my way down the whole entire board, making sure I got all mesh areas. Finger. Making sure I got all mesh areas covered. Any excess you have, you can just scrape it down all the way across the board, and that would help. With palette boards, they have creases, so you have to make sure the creases aren't your creases aren't filled with excess paint, excess paste, because sometimes the excess paste can get stuck in the crease within the creases and stay there, and it can bleed throughout the cracks. So you don't want that. So you want to make sure any of your cracks are not filled with paste. All right, so I'm going to wipe the excess off. I'm going to get the excess off of my transfer now. Just going straight across, straight up and down. Kind of like a cleaning excess process. And just letting you know that you have every bit of the mesh part covered. Then I'm gonna look at any of the cracks that I may have, so I can make sure when I peel it, it's not gonna bleed across. I think we're good. All right, so I'm gonna put that to the side. And I'm gonna go ahead and peel. I'm gonna go ahead and peel up. I'm gonna peel from the bottom and just peel straight up. Making sure I don't peel none of the paste, but have a little area right here that I need to pay a little bit of attention to. Alright, I'm going to peel up again. I'm going to peel it from the middle. Right here at the top, we got a little area that we need to get. This is the joy of this, because you can definitely see where you're at with your wording and things like that. Turned out super cute. Okay, so I have to use the wording for this. So what I'm gonna do is I have to put this to the side for a moment because I'm gonna need to use it really quickly. I have to bring out my blow dryer because I have to blow dry the wording. So one moment with that. So I can do the word, the name. Just lay that particular area down, not anywhere else. And then I'm going to paste. Thank you. got this one a little messy. Grab my mini one. Go across the name. One more covering with the excess to make sure I'm getting every bit of the name. And I'll wipe the excess off again, and then I'll just peel up from down here because it's not that much to peel up. I'm gonna lay my water in face down, lay my transfer in the water face down, and then I think we're good. It's a cute little board. Turned out really cute. The name across the bottom in the corner. Super cute. So that's how it kind of helps a little bit with the surfacing part, with the parts of with the parts of when it comes to waxing these kind of boards, you definitely need to make sure you get every inch of the board, because it helps with the sticking, making sure everything sticks and things like that. So you want to make sure you have that on the board to definitely work out. So that is the process of my waxing when it comes to waxing my boards or anything like that. If you have any questions, you can definitely comment below. I will get back to you with any of your questions that you may have. I have sample kits posted on my Etsy shop. I will post that link if you want to check those out. If you want any of the products that I'm using throughout any of my videos, you can check out my chalk site, and I will post that link in the description. Also, you can follow me on Instagram at creationsbyautumn1. Get a little bit of more information about, you know, just some of the things, some updates and things like that. For instance, like June promotions, I'll have June promotions posted on there, especially for the promotions that we have for Club Couture. It's more promotions that we have. So if you're looking for any other promotions that may be available, they're just posted monthly. So June promotions, I'll post and give you a little update. If you have any questions about any of the promotions, you can definitely comment comment below for any promotions, and I can get back with you with that. If you would like to join my team, you can comment join. If you would like to become a member of Club Couture or get more information on Club Couture, you can comment club. Also, everything that I'm using, like from the paste, the products, like different sized products, some surfaces that I use throughout my videos are listed on my chalk site. So my chalk site will be linked below. Thank you guys for watching, and I appreciate you, your support and everything like that. Please make sure you like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell, and I will see you next time. Thank you guys. Bye.